today's topic is conic section. In conic section we have to deal with the circle, parabola, ellipse and hyperbola. In that today we will see the standard form of the ellipse. First of all we should know what is meant by conic section, because in first year we have learned in conic section how to solve with c square with the formulas of c, but here we will see all the formulas with respect to constant ratio eccentricity. As conic is the set of points in a plane whose distances from a fixed point called focus, namely we have done in the first year f dash, but here we put as s, because what are the material, you see these type of formulas only we have with respect to the s, and a fixed line, fixed straight line, namely directrix, are in a constant ratio r in a constant ratio e called eccentricity. That is, the diagram is fixed point s, will take it as focus. Fixed line will take it as directrix. Let P be any point in the locus. Now SP by PM equal to E is the constant ratio. If this constant ratio called E, if this constant ratio E named as eccentricity, if this eccentricity, if E equals to 1 called parabola, that means the constant ratio if E equal to 1 is called parabola, if E less than 1 called ellipse, if E greater than 1 call it as hyperbola. Because we will take today ellipse topic, and in KCET totally coordinate geometry they are giving the 10 questions, and in JEE ellipse and conic section itself getting 2 to 5 questions. Therefore this is how we will get with the constant ratio parabola, ellipse, hyperbola. Now we will see the standard form of ellipse. Proof of standard form of ellipse is x square by a square plus y square by b square equals to 1. The diagram is, we will take the ellipse is on x axis as the standard form of the ellipse. Fixed points will have S, S dash. As we are having two focuses, we name it as foci. And we are having directrix L, L dash. It is on x axis and y axis. That vertices are A, A dash. And on minor axis B, B dash. On which axis we are having ellipse, it is called as major axis. Ellipse which is not on the axis is called as minor axis. Therefore the length of the major as A dash equals to 2A. length of the minor axis BB dash equals to 2B. Let P be any point on the ellipse. SP and P to the directrix PM is called perpendicular distance from point P x comma y to the directrix. Therefore, we have to find out the focus and as well as the equation of the directrix. For that, now we'll make two ratios along like SP by PM equal to A. Now we'll get SA by AZ, SA dash SA by AZ equals to E, E equals to SA dash by A dash Z. With this, we try to find out the focus as well as the equation of the directrix. With this constant ratio, you can write SA equals to E A Z. Now, SA from the diagram is nothing but here we have to make the center. Center at origin only we are taking. Therefore, to get the value of SA, we have to make CA total distance from center to the vertex CA minus CS equals to E into AZ we will get from the center CZ minus CA. This we will name it as 1. And from the constant ratio SA dash equals to E A dash Z, SA dash is nothing but CS plus CA dash equals to E into A dash Z is nothing but CA dash plus C. This will take it as 2. And here from the diagram, CA equals to CA dash equals to A. As length of the major axis is 2A. Now, adding 1 and 2. Adding 1 and 2. What is 1 we are having here? CA minus CS equals to ECZ minus ECA. Therefore, and 2 is CA dash plus CS equals to ECZ plus ECA dash. Since we know that CA equal to CA dash equal to A, these two are same. These two get cancelled. And here plus CS minus S get cancelled. CA plus CA dash we will get here 2ECZ we will get. A plus A will have 2A. 2ECZ. 2 to get cancelled. CZ equals to A by A. Where CZ is nothing but the distance of X. Therefore, we are getting X equals to A by E, which is equation of directrix. Which is equation of directrix. Now, subtracting 1 minus 2, CA minus CS equal to ECZ minus ECA, making minus, minus CA dash minus CS equals to minus ECZ minus ECA dash. Now with this, plus minus these two will get cancelled. Plus minus these two will get cancelled. Minus 2CS equals to, as we know that CA and CA dash are both are same, we will take it as minus 2EA. Because CA and CA dash value is A. Minus A minus A. Minus AE minus A, we take it as minus 2AE. Minus 2 minus 2 get cancelled. We are having CS equals to A. This is nothing but from center C to the focus. That means distance from origin to the S. Therefore, the focus we got now. Focus we got AE comma CL. as it is we have to consider both the sides, foci will make it as plus or minus e comma 0, and here also this implies x equal to plus or minus a by e, both positive side as well as negative side of the equation of the directrix. Now as we got the focus and the equation of the directrix, now we have to find out the equation of the ellipse in standard form PPM, where PM is the perpendicular distance from point P x comma y. SP is distance from the focus to the point P x comma y, that S we are having AE comma 0, and let P be any point x comma y on the ellipse. Therefore SP we are having x minus AE whole square plus y minus 0 whole square equals to E into PM is perpendicular distance x minus a by e hold over root over a square plus b square. X quotient only we are having and y quotient we are not having, therefore it is 0. Squaring on both sides will have x minus a e whole square plus y square equals to e square into modulus will take it as positive a by e whole square. With this if you expand x square plus a square e square minus 2a e x plus y square equals to e square into x square plus a square by e square minus 2a by e x. Take the e square multiple with the bracket or take e square inside that. We will have x square plus y square minus 2a e x plus a square e square x square e square plus a square minus 2a e x. These two will get cancelled. Bring x square terms one side and remaining constant that side, we will have x square minus x square e square plus y square equal to a square minus a square e square. If you take x square common, we will have 1 minus e square plus y square equals to a square. If you take common, we will have 1 minus e square. To get the required equation x square by a square plus y square by b square equals to 1, we have to divide whole equation by a square into 1 minus e square. Therefore, we will get here x square by a square plus y square by a square into 1 minus e square equals to 1, where b square equals to a square into 1 minus e square. With this, we will have, therefore, the standard equation of the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equals to 1. And with this we can find out the eccentricity formula E also, as b square equals to a square minus a square e square. A square e square equal to, we can add a square minus b square. E square equals to a square minus b square by a square, where E equals to root over a square minus b square by a square. Now this standard form only we will consider as a greater than b as entered origin 0 0 center c at 0 0 as in various forms of ellipse, we will take it as one of the case, and if a less than b we will take it as ellipse is on y axis, that various forms we will see. Thank you.